In the vast expanse of the American West, where ecosystems bear the scars of time, natural forces, and human intervention, a beacon of hope emerges. The Bureau of Land Management, with funds provided by the Inflation Reduction Act, embarked on an initiative to breathe new life into the landscape. A monumental $161 million investment from Congress and the White House is set to flow into 21 ecosystems designated for restoration across 11 states, laying the groundwork for a transformative journey, one that begins in Wyoming.
Slow the water and create wetlands in this area. That's the whole point of these beaver dam analogs, which means we just mimic beaver dam habitat with the hope that someday maybe one will come in and create a little family and do the work for us.
Janet Bellis is the hydrologist leading the charge for the Bureau to restore resilience to the waterways of the western corridors of Wyoming.
Mainly it's to look at how to prevent further erosion throughout this entire area.
Environmental protection specialist Alex Arts delves into the intricate web of compounding factors that were once neglected but are now a focal point for restoration.
So we're just trying to help restore some of these areas before they keep getting any worse. Mm-hmm. Planting some of these plants along the bank here to help stabilize it a little quicker.
A vital mix of environmental engineering and indigenous knowledge is working to help heal the landscape. This technique will help balance an ecosystem now dealing with idle oil and gas wells, erosion, and invasive grasses.
I've been very impressed working with this crew. They are archaeological technicians.
The project area is in the ancestral homeland of the Northern Arapahoe and other tribes. The tribe's involvement is a critical element to understanding the archaeological and cultural aspects of landscape restoration.
This is a grinding stone.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever you find any kind of artifact, you put it back in the exact same spot, in the exact same way.
Emphasizing the importance of preserving not only the land, but also the rich cultural heritage intertwined with it.
This is a huge big game wintering area, so there's all kinds of conflicting uses here. Tons of wildlife use, migrating birds, sage grouse.
The goal of this project is to maintain that intricate dance between multiple uses of the lands and the urgent need to protect the habitat of keystone species like the greater sage grouse.
Sagebrush ecosystem is really important habitat in huge chunks of the West.
These restoration efforts are not just about reclaiming land. They're about putting people back to work, revitalizing ecosystems, and preserving the delicate balance that sustains life across the country for future generations.
You hope that you can slow down the water flow, decrease the erosion, and have kind of some compounding effects as you go further downstream.
As the nation's largest public lands manager, the Bureau of Land Management restored millions of acres. By focusing on collaboration in these prioritized landscapes, this historic funding will engage partners more efficiently to articulate the Bureau's vision. In this part of Wyoming, this unprecedented investment signals a turning point, a renewed commitment to a more resilient and inclusive future, one where the richness of these natural resources and many uses of the land are known for generations to come.